There are 14 million people becoming homeless each year across the globe because of natural disasters.
When natural disasters happen, they exacerbate inequities.
They plunge an additional 26 million people into poverty every year.
Infrastructure is generally built to higher standards than homes.
Housing is an essential component of the climate change agenda.
Housing should be part of the climate change agenda because we have a powerful opportunity to attack both climate change and housing instability together.
Housing should be part of a climate change agenda because you can't talk about climate without talking about where people live and how long they have to drive to get to work.
Housing should be part of the climate change agenda because home is where the impact of climate change is felt the most.
Housing should be part of the climate change agenda because the impacts of climate change are destroying the homes of the poorest families on Earth.
Housing should be part of the climate change agenda because more than two-thirds of the built environment is residential, and homes are the weak underbelly of communities when it comes to hazard resilience.
Kailangan ng tamang design ng bahay ngayon kasi nagbabago na ang panahon. Mas malakas na ang mga bagyong dumarating kaya dapat matibay.
Pretty much was preparing for a windstorm and they told us we was going to have a substantial amount of rain, but I couldn't imagine.
Ating nakatira sa isang mababang lugar. Noon naranasan ko na ang matinding hagupit ng baha. Na minsan ang pagbaha ay umabot sa Amambewa at sa ibang lugar ay lampas tawa.
Porque ahorita tenemos cambio climático, hay muchos vientos, hay veces muchos soles, muchas lluvias.
Let's take the case of Hurricane Katrina. Fully 40% of the residents at that time left the city and never returned.
Here in Rwanda, tens of thousands of people lost their homes in record-breaking rain, causing tons of landslides.
The average American home, unfortunately, is pretty brittle. It's not designed to be resilient. When people brag about their house being built to code, it's really nothing to brag about.
Zoning policies are limiting the development of multifamily housing in denser urban areas.
Affordable housing is typically located further from jobs, schools, and services. And with the booming housing markets, development is pushing further and further from the town cores, thereby creating more greenhouse gas.
A bold solution we're advocating for here in California is to change the way we zone for housing to allow for more housing density near job centers and near public transportation. So instead of building in wildfire zones, we can instead focus in sustainable areas near jobs and near transit.
A bold solution we're advocating for is equitable fire safety policies that benefit all of society.
A bold solution that we're implementing in Rwanda and Uganda is using local earthen materials to build beautiful, durable, and very sustainable housing products.
There have been quite a few examples of pre-planning and design and construction proven to be very efficient in disasters like this.
For too long, we have worked against nature, ignored the skills of indigenous communities, and dismissed the threat of climate change. The time to act is now.
We have to enact housing reform now. We need more sustainable land use.
The time to act is now, before the next natural disaster.
The time to act is now, before the next heavy rain that causes that next deadly landslide.
Before the next big earthquake.
The time to act is now, before the next flood or hurricane.
Homeowners, business leaders, government officials, housing activists, and builders from around the globe all agree housing must be on the climate change agenda. The resilient, affordable, equitable future we all deserve depends on actions we take now, in every house, in every neighborhood, everywhere. Together, we can change climate change. Join us.